हेलो, वेलकम टू द हैंड्स ऑन लैब एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड हियर टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू दैट हाउ यू कैन रन थिन लेयर क्रोमेटोग्राफी एक्सपेरिमेंट एट योर होम यूजिंग सिंपल थिंग्स विच आर अवेलेबल एट होम एंड हियर आई हैव टेकन दीज थ्री जार्स नंबर वन नंबर टू एंड नंबर थ्री एंड इन दीज थ्री जार्स आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड वन individual three, they look like a pad, but I made this like a mimicking like a thin layer chromatography TLC plates. So how we can make these kind of TLC plates? So you can use any cardboard like this one. I'm using this cardboard, and then I cut this into small pieces, just like a. Here this is a around one and a half inch wide, and this is around four and a half inch tall. So cut these two small pieces, and then here I have this paper towel, which is this is the last piece that I have here. So this is the paper towel I'm using here. And then I cut this paper towel like this way. You can cut it. So paper towel is available at our home, and cardboard is also very easily you can find it. So mostly all the things are available in our kitchen or in our home which we can utilize. So I make this a double like this one, double it. And then wrap like this. And then what I did, once you wrap it, use this sticky tape to tape it. One. Then number two. And then number three. So on back side we can see there are three tapes, and then front side is only double layer of this cardboard paper towel, and then I can cut so that it will be straight. And then from here also, if you do not have the tape, that's okay, still we can do it. So here you can see I made these two thin layer chromatographic plate. If you do not have tape, you can use a paper clip and make like this one. So here I made three glass bottle jar, which is also available. If you don't have these bottle, you can make a smaller TLC plates, or you can use plastic glass. So here we have three plates, and in these three jar I am labeling them like a jar A will be contain only water. So jar A, this is my jar A, which will have only water. And then let's move these TLC on the back side, and then jar B, this is the jar B, which I will fill with the oil, vegetable oil and water, 50-50, one and one. And then here I have third jar, which is will be filled with the oil only. And how much we are going to fill, I will show you here. So here I'm using this table spoon, which is we use in basically in our kitchen. So I'm adding here, you can see half tablespoon 1, half tablespoon 2, half tablespoon 3, and half tablespoon 4. So I'm adding half tablespoon 4 times, it means 2 tablespoon water, and close it. Next, 1, 2, so only 2 tablespoons of water Actually, I have to add a little bit more here because this is a little bit deep. So I'm adding three of them. So three, and then let's wipe it. And here I have this vegetable oil. This is the vegetable oil. And you can use any vegetable oil like canola oil or... So I'm going to add here, you can see this number 1 tablespoon, 1/2 tablespoon, 1/2 tablespoon, 2 and 1/2 tablespoon, 3. So now this become a 50-50 mixture. And in this jar, I'm going to add 100% oil only. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So basically, now our solvents are ready. In this one, this is 100% oil, which is jar C. This is jar A, which is 100% water. And in this jar B, we have 50% oil, 50% water. So I'm going to mix it. Let's mix like this. So once it will mix, that's nice. And then now what I will do with this, so I'm going to use this TLC plates. So first, I will mark, pencil mark. So from the bottom, I'm going to half an inch pencil mark. So make a line, 1/2 inch in all three of them, very gently. So this is number one. Number two, TLC plate, 1/2 inch is here. Now I know where is my 1/2 inch. This is number two. And number three is this one, where I'm going to add 1/2 inch of, again, the line. So three TLC plates are ready. And now I'm going to add here three dots. So I'm using this Crayola red color. So I will put one spot very gently, like this one is small, so that I can see. You can see red dot on the far left corner. So red dot means we have one compound which is red color. And then in all three, you can see I added three dots here, 1, 2, 3. And then in the next, I'm going to add here, this is the watercolor or food color. And for food color, how I'm going to add food color, here I'm taking this this is a wooden stick, toothpick stick. So what I did here, you can see I just cut its tip so that it should not be very sharp. And then I open this bottle, slowly dip some blue color. And then make it on the spot it on the center of this TLC. So now you can see this is the second spot. Blue and red is already there. We will do the same thing for the second TLC. And this is the third one. Very small spot we have to put it, right? Now this second compound we have spotted on our TLC. And then third one is little different. I'm using this black pen. So let's very gently I have to add some black pen ink. Now I have here black pen ink. So red, blue and black. In the next, same thing I have to do in this one also. Slightly, very light. And in the third one, I also add here we should not disturb the paper. So now the three compounds, red, blue and black, they are on the TSC paper. So let's start to run them on the first in jar number one. So let's take a closer look. I'm using here jar number one, and then we'll keep move little bit ahead, left side. This is jar number one, 100% water. And then now I'm going to add this TLC in the 100% water. So let's see what will happen. You can see water is fastly moving, very fast moving. And if you see this TLC, how nicely the color is moving up. And we want to see which color move and how far. So this TLC, this paper is water absorbent. It's and blue color and red color both are water soluble, so that is why they have very good run on this TLC. So the TLC is basically, it is called a stationary phase, and the liquid or water which is in the jar is the mobile phase, and this is a basically polar TLC we have made it. So water is still running. If you see, let me zoom it. I cannot shake it too much, but so let's give little bit time so that it can run and see how far it can be run. In case of, if you are using in the lab organic chemistry TLC, these spots will directly move and you will not see any line. There should not be a streak. And here it is a streak because this compound is absorbing on the paper very fast. So this is the one experiment with the jar number one. And I'm going to remove it from here. And we'll note down what are the heights. So let's remove it. And then here you can see this is my water height. This is solvent. And blue color is little bit higher than the red color. And black color is very low. So I will note down the height. So basically you can see water is moved from around 6.5 centimeter. 6.5 centimeter solvent, and then blue color height is around 6 centimeter. Blue is 6 centimeter, and then red is around 4.5 centimeter, 4.5 centimeter, and then black is hardly moving, which is around maybe 1 centimeter. That's it. Oh, sorry, this is the red one is 4.5 and black is 1 centimeter. So from one experiment, we have collected these data.
which is in the first TLC, if we are using mobile phase as a water, solvent means water, run 6.5 centimeter, red compound move 4.5 centimeter, blue compound move 6 centimeter, black compound move 1 centimeter. Now you can calculate the RF. So before watching this video, I will highly suggest you read the theory of this one. And now we are going to set up the another experiment with this mixture. So in this jar, we have water and oil 1 to 1, which is 50-50%. And just shake it. So now you can, I will zoom it a little bit and make it center so that we can see, and place it gently. Make sure the solvent in the bottle must be below the spot, otherwise they will go at the bottom. So gently I will place it here and we'll see if these spots are moving, how fast is moving. So still here you can see the water is there and oil is there, but because of the water, these spots are moving ahead. So we'll give a few minutes, maybe 1 minute, so that let it run this TLC. I would like to zoom it so that you can see how nicely it is moving. So if you are doing this experiment in the lab, usually we keep the TLC chamber always covered so that solvent don't evaporate. And if the compound have different mobility with the different solvent, like hydrophilic compound will move with the water and hydrophobic compound will move with the oil. So here we will see what will be the difference is happening. Now I think I will remove this TLC. If you remove one time from the glass, you cannot dip again. So make sure I'm just touching from inside to see if it is wet or not. So water is move ahead here. So I'm going to remove it, this TLC now. And we'll quickly note down the height. So water move up to this place. And again, here you can see in this one, this is the blue color. Red color is up to here, and I do not see any movement for this black color. Black color is still there, and this TLC become like a making of like waves because this paper got swollen. Anyway, so we'll read their readings now. So this is around 6.8 centimeter solvent move 6.8 centimeter. Let's zoom out a little bit. Centimeter solvent has moved, basically mostly water has moved, and then blue color is still has the highest. It's around 6 centimeter. What about the black color? Black color is hardly any movement I can see. I do not see almost zero
Black color 0 cm.
And what about the red one? Red is around 5 cm. So this is my second TLC experiment, and we have noted down the readings for three different compound, three different color. For solvent, 6.8 cm, red is 5.0 cm, blue is 6.0 cm, black is 0 cm. Now you can calculate the RF for these three values. Now we'll come back to our third experiment. And in this third experiment, we have 100% oil, which is vegetable oil. And so we need not to shake it. It's very easy. And this is my third TLC. Red color, blue color, and black color. And now I'm going to add this TLC in this chamber. And we'll see if any movement is happening here. So oil have very slow movement in this type of jar or in this paper. I would like to show you by zooming, see if any spot is also moving or not. So based on this TLC experiments, you can think that you are running three compounds on the TLC, and you can decide what are the polarities are there, and how, which polar compound, if the compound is polar or not. So let's give little bit time for this one. Oil have very slow movement in this TLC, and I cannot see if any color is also moving. So basically this shows that the compounds are polar, and that is why they were moving in the water and oil system, but not in the oil system. So this experiment you can perform with your own, utilizing this all the ingredients which are available in our kitchen, and try to learn what is the TLC thin layer chromatography at your home, and then perform some data experiment for your lab reports. We'll give one more minute for this oil to move. And we are seeing any hardly movement. So you can see there is no movement have observed in this experiment. So let's remove this TLC from this chamber, because we are seeing that these compounds are not moving in the TLC chamber, because they are polar compound and they cannot move through the non-polar solvent, which is oil. So now I'm going to remove this one from here. But we will write down I just want to soak this oil from the bottom, and now we'll make a mark how far it move. So basically it move, the oil move only this side. And if I will give you very closer look here, you can see the red spot and blue spot and the black spot, they are all at one place. Hardly any movement we have observed. So what is the height of the solvent here? The height of solvent is around 2.5 centimeter. So we'll note down that 2.5 centimeter solvent has moved. And does any color has moved? No, this color I did not observe any color movement. So it will be 0 centimeter, 0 centimeter, and 0 centimeter. So out of these experiment, so now you can see, so let's rearrange those one once again. So here we have, this is jar 1, jar A, which is 100% water, and here we got very nice solvent run and red color, black color and blue color height, and it's compound run, and here we have mixture of the solvent, and then you can see the TLC have different movement of the compound. But in case of oil, we did not observe any movement. So this shows that all these color compound are kind of polar, but blue color is the highest polar than the red one, and the black color has very, very low polarity. Here you can see it move only 1 centimeter. So now using these data, I'm going to add these data in the comment description box, and you have to calculate the RF of each spot and explain about these compounds, what is going on and what are the nature of the compound and the polarity. Discuss about the polarity in the different solvent. So this was the experiment which you can perform at home to learn how the TLC works in the lab and how we monitor thin layer chromatography technique to monitor the reaction progress. Okay, thank you.